Hi student, today we are going to perform the VI characteristics of the LED light emitting diode in forward bias characteristics. This is the circuit diagram for LED in forward bias diagram. The LED anode is connected to the positive of the supply and the cathode is connected to the supply negative terminal. Here required components are LED light emitting diode. The here longest terminal is anode and shortest terminal is cathode. And required resistor is 1 kilo ohm resistor and multimeter, voltmeter, ammeter and regulator power supply and breadboard. Now connect the circuit diagram as per the circuit diagram. By LED light emitting diode, anode and cathode. Anode is connected here and cathode is connected to the ground. Next supply, regulator power supply, positive is connected to one of the terminal here. One of the node here, I am connecting here this one node. From node to resistor here, positive terminal to regulator power supply, positive to one end of the resistor, one end of the resistor. I am connected second end to some other node. And second end terminal resistor of the two multimeter, ammeter positive, ammeter positive. This is ammeter positive. And negative is connected to the LED anode. I am connecting anode to here. Okay. And supply negative is connected to the cathode of the LED. Cathode of the LED. And voltmeter is connected across the LED. Means parallel to the LED. So voltmeter positive is connected to the LED anode terminal and negative is connected to the cathode of the terminal. Let's do the practical. Now on the regulator power supply, switch on the regulator power supply and on the ammeter, keep it in 20 milliamps and multimeter, voltmeter in voltage mode. Now tabular column is VS supply voltage, LED voltage, voltage across the LED and forward current milliamps, FIF and intensity of the glow. Okay, now increase the voltage, supply voltage, one step of 1 volt. Next, I am increasing for 1 volt, we are getting output voltage across the diode also, LED also 1 volt. So, current will be 0 and there is no intensity. Next, increase 1 volt to 2 volts. So, VL is diode across the LED is 1.7 volts, 1.765 volts. IF is current is 0.22 milliamps and glow is approximately zero. There is no glowing here. Next step is 3 volts, 2 to 3 volts. Increase the voltage to 3 volts. And voltage is 1.863 volts, current is 1.24 milliamps and LED is glowing. Okay, so glow, light glow. Next increase supply voltage to 4 volts. So LED intensity is glowing more. So current increases, glowing of the LED also increases. So voltage is per volt 4 volts, VL is 1.970 volts, IF is 2.12 milliamps and LED is glowing more than before voltage. Next to 5 volts, per 5 volts, supply voltage 5 volts, voltage is 1.986 and current is 3.10 and LED is glowing. Next 5 to 6 volts, increase the 5 volts to 6 volts, voltage is 2.04 to current is 4.07, LED is glowing more compared to before. For LED 7 volts, supply voltage 7 volts, so VL is 2.05, to current is 5.14, and LED is glowing more compared to before it. For next, increase to supply voltage 8 volts. 8 volts, VL is 2.094 and current is 6.12, and LED is glowing more. The current is increases, LED also glowing more compared to before current, or compared to this. Next, current is 9, supply voltage is 9 volts. Supply voltage is 9 volts, voltage VL is 2.161 and current is 6.99, LED is glowing. Next, 10 is, supply voltage is 10 volts, voltage is 2.193, current is 7.96. Okay, from these values you can draw the graph. Okay. From this graph you can take the values. For 1 volt, VL is 1 volt, current is 0, approximately 0 here, and 1.76, sorry, VL is 1.765, 1.6 here, 1.7 here, 1.765 here, current is 0 again. 1.8, VL is 1.863, VL is 1.863, 63 is here, we are getting here, 1.85, 1.65, we are getting here, current is 1.24 milliamps, 1.1 here, 1.5 here, 1.24 is approximately you will get here. Next, 1.97, VL is 1.97, 1.98, 1.2, 1.9 here, 1.97 is approximately here, and current is 2.12. Yeah, you will get here. Next, current is, voltage is 1.986, you will get here. Current is 3.10. Voltage is 2.04, current is 4 point something. So 2 volts, approximately 2 volts, current is 4. For 2.05 is approximately here only, and current is 5.14 here you will get. 2.094 means 2.1, approximately 2.1, here you will get 2.1, current is 6.12, you will get here. Next, current is, voltage is 2.16 here, 2.16 here, you will get, and current is 6.99, approximately 7 volts, 7 milliamps, you will get here. Next, 2.193 means approximately 2.2, and current is 7.96 means 8 volts, 8 milliamps, 2.2, 8 milliamps approximately here. Okay, connect this points and draw the graph. So draw the smooth. Okay, you can determine this resistor value whatever you have used in the practical experiment. Here we have used 1 kilo ohm resistor. You can determine this value by using this graph also. So you can locate the one point on the graph. So I am using 2, 5. From this, I am looking at this. This is now I am assuming Q point. So 2, 5. X axis 2 volts. Y axis 5 milliamps. So you can measure the value. Determine, derive the value, resistor value here. So R equal to, formula will be R equal to Vs minus VL by I. 5 milliamps, Vs is 7 volts and VL is 2 volts. So 7 minus 2, 5. So you can write down here, Vs is at 5 milliamps current, at 5 milliamps current, Vs is 7 volts and VL is 2 volts. So you will get 5 by 5 milliamps. So you will get approximately 1 kilo ohms. You can derive from this formula, and you can use any resistor. By using this resistor, you require any current.